Hello there, my name is Dominic and today I'm going to show you all you needed to know about the LG TV Plus application. I'm using this application on an Android device and with this application, I can control my television. You can see I have the pointer over here. I can even use my navigation. I can even change channels from this application. I can even control the applications on my television using this. Let me launch YouTube and I can even select a video from one of my videos to view. I can even manipulate the volume and reduce the volume. I can mute and mute. I can even use 3D if your television has 3D. Now, let us go to the beginning. How do you pair this application to your television? The LG TV Plus application is available on both the Apple App Store as well as Google Play Store. It is a free application from LG Electronics and does not have any third-party advertisements. This application can be used instead of the LG Magic Remote Controls. Any LG Smart TV that was sold without the Magic Remote Control will also work with this application. So if your Magic Remote is lost, broken, or has run out of batteries, you will still be able to control your LG television. Some of these Magic Remotes are very expensive, so you can always use your smartphone instead of buying a brand new remote control. First of all, you need to find this application and install it into your smartphone and open it. Before pairing this application, you need to do something. Go to the settings on your television. My television is connected to the internet using an Ethernet cable and my smartphone over here is connected to the same network using Wi-Fi. So your two devices, your television and your smartphone must be connected to the same network. Notice I'm not saying Wi-Fi because you can see my TV is connected using the Ethernet cable and my phone is on Wi-Fi. So they must be connected to the same network, preferably the same router. After that, come to LG Connect Apps and make sure that it's not off. Because if it's off, the application will not work, so make sure it's on. The revoke pairing over here revokes any pairing that has been done from any smartphone to the specific LG television. You are about to revoke all pairing authorizations. Just say yes. So I'm going to launch my application yet again and I'm going to show you how to pair this application to your LG TV. You can see it says look for another TV. I just click look for another TV and it has already found my television. I just click on that television. To avoid misuse, LG has this process whereby you must enter the PIN shown on your LG TV because we don't want anyone just pairing with your LG television and done. I'm now connected. The main menu over here has three items: the remote control, mobile content, and LG TV Plus app settings. You will want to read the about page about this application. You also want to read the end user license agreement from LG software. So let us go to remote control. At the bottom over here, I can change the input of my LG television. I'm going to select TV. At the bottom over here, I can select the TV app list, program list, TV inputs, and TV settings. Let me select TV app list. You can see I have Showmax over here. I can launch Showmax. I can also launch Netflix. Now, while in TV app list, I can select program list. And here, I can select any channel that I want and it will immediately change on the television. I'm going to select EduTV. And there you have EduTV. You can even favorite any programs that you deem are your favorites and they will appear on the favorite program list. You can even remove them. You can even change the input on your television, for example, can change to HDMI 2 and select OK. And there you have HDMI 2. Now let me go back to YouTube, TV app list, and YouTube. Over here I have the choice of using either the mouse wheel over here or the navigation button over here. Now let me go to mobile content. With this application, I can play anything from my smartphone to the TV. And I'm going to select a screenshot that I did before, and I play it at the top over there. You can see buffering in progress. And here is my screenshot. So I can actually show photos that I took from my smartphone over to the television. I will now play this video from my Instagram. And there is the video. You can see it's quite fast. It almost plays immediately, but this depends on the file size, because heavy file sizes will not just play immediately. I can even play music. The music is playing at the top over there, but because of copyright, I'm not going to enable the volume. Now, if I go back, the music usually stops immediately. You must keep this page active for the file to play over there. If I exit from this place, the file will also exit on the LG television screen. The last thing I'm going to show you is switching off the television from the application. I can switch it off, but you can see this notification over here. If you turn off the TV, connection with the app will end. Do you want to continue? If you say yes, the TV will turn off. But now you won't be able to turn it on using your application. You can only use your remote control or the button on your LG television. Every time you switch on your television, you must also pair it again. So thank you for watching. I hope you learned something new today, and goodbye.